introducing to you the current solutions. The current solutions. We have talked about our problems. Right now, for the main quiz, we want to talk about the current solution that exists. Because some of you may think that, no, maybe you can do this, do that, but I want to really show you what it is really like, the solutions. So the first, so here are the various solutions encapsulated in the cable. We have the mobile phone. Because one with the mobile phone, you can access a lot of people. PowerPoints, fax medical questions, Google Translate, PDF, WhatsApp, Google itself, Google Search, and ChatGPT. Okay. So let's start with the phone. So let's start with the phone. The phone, I love the phone in particular. It's good because it provides us access to just so many things. And notably, I want to highlight the fact that with the use of the phone, you can have everything in one place. Except with the phone, you can't have the physical copy of a book. And that is one major drawback that I faced in school. Because in my own medical school, yes, we had notes from the professors through other PDFs or PowerPoints. Yes, we had Google Translate. Yes, we had ChatGPT. Yes, we had Google Translate and the rest. But each and every one of them had some limitations. So let's start with the phone. In the case of the phone, The phone actually is good because just anyone can get a phone. But the limiting factor in having a phone to study is the fact that it is very prone to theft. I've had so many friends that came and talked to me. And you know, when you have everything stored on just one physical gadget, I mean, the problem with the phone came at the level of theft, because at some point I had all my lectures on my phone from the first to the fourth year, and just imagine that you enter a taxi and you get harassed. I mean, how would you get back those notes? Yes, you could ask your classmates or some other people, but it should be hard to get back those same notes. The next solution we are talking about is Google Search. Now, Google Search is a powerful feature, very powerful feature. And the best thing with Google is it is accessible, easy, and easy to use. The major drawbacks I faced with using Google was that when I was studying like for my finals or for an upcoming exam, and I had a problem with a particular question. When I was search on Google, I would find 1,000 PDFs or I don't know whatever. And as an English student using Google, when you use Google Translate, for example, to translate your notes, it's actually good, but there were some terms that it wasn't able to really give a good translation. So I found out that I had a lot of information to search through, which were often too confusing, and there were times that I didn't find the information that was peculiar to my level and to my medical school. Because let me tell you, medical school everywhere is not the same thing. There was medical schools where they might ask you to describe the Krebs cycle. In my school, they would never ask you that. What they can give is maybe like some multiple choice questions on that. And so that is really something that we have to look into. Google Search is a powerful feature, but it becomes a limiting factor if you are not in the US or if your school is not in a major school. So that is one of the problems I plan to tackle. The next one is WhatsApp. Now, what do I mean by WhatsApp? By WhatsApp, I mean people. So the end users. The best thing, one of the things I love with WhatsApp was that it provided us a new way to interact with our teachers. At the same time, it provided us with PDFs and PowerPoint presentations of the class. But the limitation were, as I said, were the users. And why am I saying so? For example, imagine I didn't come for a class yesterday, and then you go to the WhatsApp group and you try to ask people, hey, can I have the notes? I mean, some people might reply to you, but not every one of them would actually do so. And so it actually becomes a problem because someone like me, for me, for example, I am very inquisitive. I love to ask questions and I love to understand. There are times that you may ask a question in the group or WhatsApp, and people will be like, oh, why are you asking this much questions? Why are you like? And that's when you need because you know, it will create this fear in you for wanting to interact with others or let us say, it becomes a limiting factor in the sense that your experience on WhatsApp is highly dependent on the quality of the users. And so with MedQuiz, we wanted to change that. Our next solution that exists are fast questions and ChatGPT. So ChatGPT came out in December, and here's what I found out. Okay, thanks for the presentation. I found a mistake in the PowerPoint. I wasn't presenting the right PowerPoint, so now I have to start back. I have to retrieve the previous one before it gets edited, else I'll be crying. Thank you. But, oh my goodness, I don't know.